and we've got a little surprise up our sleeves. What's that? It's the Jump 2015!
It's a bit of a bumpy ride. Fast speed at the fastest point of the course. Oh, but he was really high there. Now she's all over the place trying to get in.
Oh, that sucks!
Tonight we're saying goodbye to Lady B.
Only chance I have of winning is taking you out.
We're going to be the most aggressive event so far.
Losing is not an option.
If I fall, everyone's coming down with me.
People are going to break bones. It's going to be a bloodbath.
Don't need to win it. Anyone who's in my way is getting taken out.
Form it, do it, do it.
I don't like it.
Ski cross is a little bit argy-bargy.
We're talking about rugby on skis.
Don't try and mess with me.
Things just got real.
It's quadruple naughty, mate. I'm going to be lucky if my brain don't explode. Oh.
Good evening and welcome to the Jump Live from Austria! Yep, tonight we're back in our home from home, 6,500 feet above sea level on Jump Mountain. We've tugged our bell all the way up here. Our celebrities are desperate to get their little mitts on it. Just look, it's frozen. It's actually frozen. There's going to be a lot of nerves tonight. They are all going to be racing completely live in the punishing ski cross, desperately hoping to avoid our heart-stopping eliminator, the air jump. Now, three are going to stay in the competition, but one will be leaving tonight. And believe me, none of them want to do that this close to the final. But wait! Hang on! Put the car in park! Hold the front page! Surprise for you. Yeah, I have. I can reveal that the person who finishes fastest overall in tonight's ski cross will win this. It is a golden ticket. It's going straight through to the Jump's final. It means that while the others are all busting a gut on Sunday, you will be kicking back, skis off, our feet up, gloating like nobody's ever gloated before.
Does that mean they don't have to snowboard?
No snowboarding.
Oh! I don't want it!
Everything for ski off. We've seen some gloating on this show, I tell you. Louis, he knows who he is. Anyway, listen, guys, how are you? Where's Joey? Joey, I saw you this morning. You looked so tired.
I was tired. I ain't really had much sleep. I've been grafting all day. I've been skiing everywhere, man. I'm a ski man, aren't I?
You are the ski man. And listen, and wait. It's someone's birthday today. Happy birthday, John. Are you having a nice day?
I'm having a brilliant day. Minus 12, sitting around, skiing. Ski cross. Oh, man.
How are you feeling about the ski cross today? Yeah. Nervous?
Like
everything to ski for.
Everything. I mean, I'm not going to get that. Let's be honest. She might get it. He might get it. I don't know.
Put some welly in. Yeah, come on. Now, listen, much as I'd love to stand around chatting, there are semi-final places at stake. So I'm going to leave you guys to go and get ready. Our celebrities, everyone. Listen, very quickly, I salute you guys. You're so brave, and I love you all. You're brilliant. Now, to avoid the air jump tonight, our celebrities are going to have to battle against the snow and each other live in ski cross. I'm telling you, the weather conditions up here, it's savage. To tell us more about it, let's hear from Graham Ding Dong Bell.
Ski cross is four skiers racing head to head, shoulder to shoulder, ski tip to ski tip, absolutely flying with no holes barred. The course will be designed to really put our competitors through their paces. Massive banked corners, huge rollers, tabletop jumps, corners with a drop-off. You really need to be a complete athlete to do well in ski cross. Our racers will be going around 40 to 50 miles an hour. Imagine doing that just meters from your opponent. To win in ski cross, you need to get out of that start gate first. You need to ski the turns well, absorb the rollers, and carry your speed over the jumps. Forget everything about manners. Look for your opponent's weak spot, and when they're weak, you attack. Because of the big jumps, massive air, hard landing, anything can happen. Someone could crash right in front of you. You could overfly a jump, run too wide in a corner, and you'll hit the netting, and that'll be you, like a fish caught in a trawler's net. Last year we had three crashes. So Steve broke a hand, broke his ribs. Marcus injured his knee. We almost lost Joe McKeldry.
I'm all right.
The difference this year is we're going to do it live. So potentially, ski cross is our most dangerous discipline.
Horrific last year, but Libby, you just said something that was quite inflammatory. Yes. We better hope that Steve Redgrave's not watching.
Yeah, they just weren't competent skiers like we were. They just weren't like the year of 2015. I mean, they weren't concentrated, they weren't dedicated.
I have to say, you guys have done absolutely brilliantly in the class of jumping and everything's been amazing.
Yeah, and literally, we are the best ones at this event. It's just unfortunate the way show's done that we're out, because we would have just...
Actually, I've got to say, I felt a bit sorry for you, Lady V, last night, because this would have been your event.
Yeah, this is actually my favourite one.
Oh, so frustrating. Bummer. And Jodie, training for it, I mean, what's this event like to do?
It's awesome, but you've got to be really tough, and you've got to really have those lines, and it's you know, it's only the toughest is going to survive.
Not the toughest. Only the toughest is going to survive.
The toughest, not tougher.
Do you know, I mean, the difficult thing is that the skis are quite long, so there's lots of sort of crossover and everything, isn't there?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's more about who gets the gate start out the fastest, and then
so you've got to go quick. You've got to get the line. So.
But you could use that length to your advantage and get out there quick.
Just I can't take him anywhere. So our celebrities are going to be split into two races. So the two fastest from each race is going to be safe. And through to Sunday night's semi-final. The others will all have to race for a second time. So the slowest three from that race will then face the air jump to stay in the competition. I know, it's exciting, isn't it? So it's time for our first ski cross race of the night. How frustrating is it that you trained for this and you can't be part of it?
Was I part of the show? Did I make it?
No, it is frustrating because I did have a lot of fun with the snow cross.
Anyway, let's find out which four celebrities are in it.
Right, guys, you made it to the ski cross. This is the lion's den for skiing.
I'm told that it's not proper to bump into people, but you're more likely to win if you do. So we're talking about rugby on skis.
Just when I think I'm getting good, along comes ski cross to reveal that I suck.
Did a lot of ski cross training with Stacy.
She celebrated a little too early.
Now she's not in the competition anymore. That makes me sad. I'd like to win it for her.
Woo! I plan on compensating for my poor skiing with physical aggression. I imagine coming through this course with a bunch of us at a time, it's gonna get pretty physical. Give me half a chance to knock JB over, I will.
I don't trust anybody in this competition, full stop. In snowcross, Steve took me out. John Allen tripped me up. There was all sorts of sabotage going on. For me, it's a little bit of a loser's tactic to be focused on bringing someone else down. When it comes to competing, I like to be fit. I like to know if I'm gonna win, I've won against all odds.
Go for it, mate, let's see you in the course.
But I think the obvious competition in this event is Louise Thompson. She's looking really good, but ski cross is a little bit argy-bargy. It's not going to be easy for her.
Go for it, guys.
It's going to be a bloodbath.
Bit of rivalry after the parallel slalom by the looks of it.
I know that Mike's probably a bit more boisterous in attacking those gates head-on, but my style is better.
I'm technically the best at ski cross, but who knows, I could be up against giants coming down there and I might not be able to squeeze through.
The ski cross draw has been made. Louise Thompson, you will be racing against JB Gill, Steve-O, and Mike Tindall.
That's the roughest heat ever.
Having four on the course might work in my favour. Can't see many of them knocking me about. And maybe I might knock a few people away. Anyone who's in the way gets moved.
Mike is a big guy, but the bigger you are, the harder you fall. Which is good for us, because if he falls, it's going to take him a lot longer to get up.
Realistically, how it'll go is I'll go hell for leather and I might end up last. Go. But if I fall, everyone's coming down with me.
Mike Tindall's obviously huge. I've seen him take out other people before. I was really annoyed to lose to Mike in the parallel slalom.
It's going to be a great time for the show!
Might have beaten me once, but ski cross is going to be my opportunity to get him back.
This heat is the heat of death.
All I'd say to the others is that they know that I'm strong, so don't try and mess with me.
I'm not the strongest skier, so only chance I have of winning is taking you out.
They're going down! Give me a woo-ha!
Woo-ha!
Give me a woo-ha!
Love it.
Wow. It's a pirate behind me. Listen, we were just talking about Louise, you know, the pocket rocket. Yeah. You were saying about getting out of the gate first. Is she going to be able to do that here?
She's a brilliant skier. Yeah. She's going to get out there. I think she really wants to get revenge back, so I think she's going to
knock him in the balls or something, but, and just get him out of the way.
But would Mike take her down?
Yes, he would.
Yeah, he would. Yeah, he would.
I know, absolutely. Yeah.
Oh, you don't think
I don't think he would. I think he really wants to snowboard. I think if Lil Lou confront and went fast,
then you think he might let her go?
Not let her, because Lil Lou's going to be fast and have the gate first.
Yeah.
So girl power.
Yeah.
No, listen, he took me out, darling, and I'm sure that he'd take Lou out.
He's lost in the skeleton. He lost in the bobsleigh. So he's got, I think he's going to go out to win.
And he really wants to snowboard, doesn't he?
Yeah, I think he might.
Anyway, listen, only first and second are going to be guaranteed a place in Sunday's semi-final. Will Louise T give our pop star a couple of big hits? Will our rugby player whoop Steve-O with his tackle?
Oh!
It's race time. Barry Davis is joined tonight by Olympic medalist Jenny Jones in the commentary box.
This is the course our celebrities have to face. It's 400 metres in length. They're skiing in sub-zero conditions. We're at over 2,000 metres here. Interesting start. It's a drop of 40 degrees, and then there are three rollers and one kicker to take on before they reach the finishing line. Well, I have to say, I agree with JB Gill. This is the group of death. The conditions are not as good as they might be, but they were worse half an hour ago, so obviously these celebrities do have influence in other circles. We're waiting now to see who gets away first. Let's check the lineup. In lane one, Mike Tindall. In lane two, Louise Thompson. In lane three, Steve-O. In lane four, JB Gill. The tension there, you can feel it. They're holding on. They've got to hold on to their ski poles as well. They want to get out quickly if they can. And Tindall is the first out and going really very well. And Louise Thompson is at the back of the field alone. Tindall could just run away with this. But he's got to be careful. Often the winner can think he's in a good position and then slips. He's being chased home and looks like Steve-O would take second place at the moment. Where is Louise Thompson? She's got to get him on the inside if she can. She's trying and she's out of the contest as Tindall comes in and Steve-O gets second. Poor Louise Thompson. JB Gill got into second place.
JB Gill got in second.
Beg your pardon?
Oh no, there was a huge crash. I'm not sure what happened.
So it's Tindall and JB Gill.
Steve-O has definitely gone down. He's still smiling though, nice to see. Yeah, it does look like Louise has gone down, but I think she's okay. She's not too. There's the pocket rocket smiling a little bit.
That's sad for her. Look how well Tindall went.
Amazing start from Tindall. Look at the power of his. He managed to push in there and get ahead. But look at the jostling going with the three at the back. Oh no, Lou, they really didn't. They didn't hold back against Lou there. Tight round the bend, Steve-O tries to come in on the inside, but he does not manage it. Tindall is so big and he's just blocking everyone out. Steve's pushing. Oh, Tindall nearly lost it on that last bend. Held it together to finish.
So congratulations, Mike. First place, well done. That's got to feel good. You were so fast out the gate.
Yeah, it was always the tactic is to try and get away first. That's the key. Because
you said the course was different.
Yeah, it always felt the last turn, I almost went. I expect, because obviously there's carnage behind it, I expected someone to pass me at the end. But
so just talk to me about what happened there, because obviously Mike was so fast out and Louise was like really, really trying to get in there with you guys.
Yeah, it's tough if you're in that first little packet, you can go around the corner. I was lucky I got to hang back a little bit. Obviously saw Steve-O go out.
So what happened with you? We hear she's getting up now, so she's okay. Yeah, I think she got tangled up in the netting.
Right, that's all that matters. I mean, I felt like I had second place, like, you know, I almost had it, but then Louise came crashing
out. She was really trying to get in there.
I promise.
Pocket rocket, she was.
I promise I didn't try to knock her over.
No, it's okay, don't worry. Listen, she's fine. She's up, she's all right. So listen, congratulations to you, Mike and JB. You are through to the semi-finals.
I just realised that
yes, no. I'm afraid you do. But congratulations to both of you guys. Listen, Steve-O, you go get yourself ready to race again. But let's hear it for you guys. Well done. Congratulations to Davey and Mike Tindall. So listen, we know the first two through to Sunday's semi-final. And coming up, we've got Louise H, John Allen, Chloe and Joey battling it out to join them. Who will win that golden ticket to the final? We'll let you know how Louise is doing. Don't worry. She's coming down right now. If we're lucky, we might be able to see her just before we hit the ad break. No, unfortunately, we can't, but she's OK. So we'll see you in a minute. Welcome back to The Jump, and we were just taking part in the ski cross before the break. Louise T had an accident, so let's just have a look at it. So, Heather, can you tell me what's happening here?
She's trying to cut him in on the inside. He's unaware, being a new skier, and he's basically gone on the back of his skis, which is always the biggest risk of having good skiers like LT and then beginner skiers like Steve.
So she was trying to take him on the inside, and basically both of them went out.
Yeah.
So I can tell you right now that Louise is okay. She's been very badly winded, and she's with the medical team, and they are assessing her at the moment to make sure that she's getting the best possible care. And I will keep you posted throughout the rest of the show to let you know how she's doing. Obviously, it's going to be very hard, I think, for the next guys to do the race knowing that this has happened.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, they might not have seen it, but they'll be aware of something happening on course, and obviously it just makes you have to wait that little bit longer. Where,
and it's difficult for you as well, because you won that race, but also it's kind of tinged with a bit of worry.
Yeah, you know, it was weird, because obviously I made a mistake at the end, and then I'm looking around going, when's LT going to pass me?
Yeah.
Obviously, as soon as I got over, I was like, well, something must have gone wrong. Well, you just hope she does.
Yeah, she will be. And congratulations on winning. And well done to you, JB, as well, to get to the semi-final. Well
Thank
done,
you.
Mate. Listen, we're about to cross skis and quite possibly swords in our second live ski cross race. So once again, four celebrities are going to race. The two fastest will join Mike and JB in Sunday's semi-final, so let's see who's in race two.
I'm not the best skier in the world, but you know, I think I'm definitely one of the bravest.
John Annan is focused, he's fast, and he has absolutely zero fear, and that is a winning combination for ski across.
Losing my arm and getting kind of blown up, or kind of anything else, like little knocks, injuries, breaks, don't really bother me. Going into ski cross to obviously win it, I think I've got a good chance in this one. You know, I'm committed, and anyone that's in my way is getting taken out.
I just get scared every time I catch up to somebody on the track that I'm going to hurt them or that they're going to hurt me, and I just back off.
Not the approach we need for ski across. Got to be aggression.
This is what you've got to do. You've got to get a bit of shot.
No! Just got to think, form it, do it. You don't think like that, you're not going to do it.
Let's be honest, being a beginner is no excuse to come race day. So I got to man up, give it everything I've got, and try and win it.
Who would you want to be paired with?
Joey, obviously.
Me and Joey are probably the worst skiers here.
Joey suffers from a low attention span.
Get those skis on and let's get you from the ski across course.
Listening is something that I've always had a bit of a problem with.
Stop working around there, six.
This is ski across, it has to be 100% focused from now on. If you don't get it right here, you could get hurt.
Man, I ain't got no sun while I'm out yet. I mean, I've got 1 out of 4 chance of winning. What's the odds on that?
Joey Essex, you are going to be up against Chloe Madeley.
Yes. What are you saying?
John Allen Butterworth.
Stay away from me.
Louise Hazel.
Yeah. Let's go, Chloe.
Take him down.
The last time I went head-to-head with our fellow jumpers,
go.
I ended up getting taken out by a wall in the snow cross. Watching the other girls cross the finish line, it was like losing the Olympic Games. Losing is not an option now. Obviously, Warren, we all want to get ahead, but what do you have to do to win?
Race day, it's going to be about getting to that first gate on time.
I'm determined to play it safe this time. And by safe, I mean I'm going flat out.
I think they think I'm quite an easy person. They'll probably be going, yeah, you know, I'm quite worried about John, I'm quite worried about Louise. I'm worried about me, man. You worried about Joey? You're worried about me? You can't eat skis.
A bit of a vendetta against Joey Essex. He beat me at the parallel slalom.
Oh, how close they can be!
I want to cross that line before him. Badly.
In ski across, the line is the most important thing. I'm going to fight my line. I'm not going to let anyone close the door on me.
I'm determined not to go down like I did in the snow cross. Get ahead of the pack, cross that finish line first.
So a hell of a lot of determination in the next pack. They're just about ready at the start. Will our heptathletes stay on track? Will Chloe Madeley send our cyclist on his bike? Will Joey Essex just be too adorable for words? It's race time. Back to Barry and Jenny in the commentary box.
Concentration, the name of the game. They've got to put out of their minds what they've just seen. Here we are. Here's the lineup for the second heat. In lane 1, Louise Hazel. In lane 2, John Allen Butterworth. Lane 3, Chloe Madeley. Lane 4, Joey Essex. Can Louise Hazel get away, which is what she will want to do? And the contest in the middle two lanes could be fascinating.
5, 8, go!
Has Hazel got away? No, she hasn't yet. It's a pretty clean break and they're all going together.
I think it's actually Joey Essex in the lead.
Yes, he is. It's amazing.
Go on, Joey.
He's looking twice to see. He doesn't want to. Louise Hazel doesn't want to jump.
Louise Hazel
chasing him, waiting for the moment. Coming around the back now. Can he keep it out? Louise Hazel. It's the first two. Oh, she's got it inside. I think he might still have held on.
my gosh.
What a finish again.
I can't.
Well, at least they all stayed on their skis this time.
Only just, only just. Joey Essex, look at the glory there, the glory moment for him. Oh, he should be claiming
that. He's going to be hoping now that his was the fastest time. And
look at the pull out there, he really pulled out. He was totally over the Wu-Tang. What a really good control, Joey. I am impressed by that. Oh, see, John Allen tried to cut in on the inside. He doesn't quite have enough speed. Oh, whose head cam are we on there? I think Louise's. Oh, Louise is really desperately trying to catch up, and Joey holds on right through the line. Oh, does he? Just!
Joey, I think, played it home, but Louise Hazel did everything she could to rob him of the victory.
I'm not entirely sure that the ski instructors will believe this, but Joey Essex is the winner! Yes. Just by a whisker, can we have a look at that? Can we have a very quick look at that? Look at that. Oh, by a hair. But congratulations to both of you, Angie, Louise, because you are through to the semi-final on Sunday night. And bad luck to both of you, but you did absolutely brilliantly. So please could you go and get ready for your next jump? Because one of you could possibly believe in tonight. Are you?
I'm so stoked, man.
Do you know what was funny? In the film of you training, they were going, oh, he's not listening to anything. But, mate, you've learned to ski on this programme.
I've learned to ski. So it's just, I've just learned to ski, and I decided my mind so focused when I just done that, and I just chocolate and had a banana, and apparently it gives you loads of energy.
Right, Mike, go stand next to Joey. So I've got here the golden ticket, and this golden ticket is your free pass to the final. No, don't take it yet. We don't know if you've won it, Joey. Because you and Mike were winners in your heats. So whoever finished fastest out of you two will win this golden ticket and the free pass to Monday's final. So let's find out your times. Mike, you were our first winner, and your time was 26.3 seconds. As you said, you had to slow down at the end. You weren't sure what was going on. You nearly fell. Joey, you were fast. Were you fast enough? You've got to beat 26.3 seconds for a place in Monday's live final. Let's find out your time. 27.62. The golden ticket's yours, Mike. You can take that. A free pass to the final. How are you feeling?
I want a snowboard.
He's upset. He wants a snowboard. After the break, our losers race again live. It doesn't matter who they are. It doesn't even matter how shiny their helmet is. Only the winner will be guaranteed a place in Sunday's semi-final. The others will have to fight for their place on this thing. But the competition really is hotting up. I've got news about Louise for you. She's been checked out by the medics. She's been super brave. She's got herself up, and she is going to race again. Which I think is brilliant. I really hope it hasn't shaken her confidence, actually. But what I've got here is a very strange situation, because these two were top of their class, and both of them are a bit unhappy, because Mike's got the golden ticket, but you really wanted that.
I really, really wanted it, because I can't snowboard, man. He's sick at snowboarding.
And you really didn't want it.
Yeah, I really wanted to race snowboard.
So you don't even want it.
I'm trying to do something right here. Anyway, listen, our celebrities have been racing it out in ski cross. It's been full on. JB, Joey and Louise H have already booked a place in the semi-final on Sunday, and Mike here has bagged, reluctantly, a golden ticket straight through to Monday night's final. Right. It is time. Louise is so brave. It's time for our last deciding ski cross race. Only the winner will be guaranteed a place in Sunday's semi-final. You can only imagine how Louise is feeling after that horrible crash. The others are going to face the air jump to stay in the competition. So it's race time. It's back to Barry and Jenny in the commentary box.
Come on, Louise.
And Louise Thompson is going to have a go at it.
You're all gonna look amazing.
And guess who's right alongside her? To her right in lane one is Steve-O. Lane two, Thompson. In lane three, John Allen Butterworth. And in lane four, Chloe Madeley. So winner takes all here. The others will be jumping.
Riders,
and a lot of
ready,
people will be hoping that Louise Thompson can get away this time. They'll all be determined, and she's so determined to get away, and she is just about in front, but she's being squeezed and being forced out. Chloe Madeley up there well, but she's got away, Thompson. Oh, this is brilliant stuff. She's being chased by Chloe Madeley and Steve-O, and I think that Louise Thompson, unless she falls, is going to win, but there's a battle for second place, and down goes one of them. I can't tell you which one it was, but I can tell you that Louise Thompson has won.
I absolutely take my hat off to Louise Thompson for getting back up there and doing that. That was absolutely amazing to see. Oh, I think John Allen had gone down.
Yeah, John Allen went down.
Oh, look at that. The adrenaline that would have been going through that girl's legs would have been intense. To see, oh, John Allen has finished. He's come through the line.
So he will have to do the jump.
Oh, she was so determined there, Louise. What a pocket rocket to come out. And even there, she almost lost it. Stevie went into the fence. And they're coming back and she brings it back together. And her skiing just shows there. She's such a good skier. Coming tight around the bends, really carving. And no one can keep up with her. No. Oh, John Allen just skids out there. Oh, look at her.
Brilliant performance by Louise Thompson.
Louise T, you won! After everything that you just went through, you are shaking like a leaf.
I know, I'm really shaken up after my first fall. And I was really not going to do this race. I was just going to let myself face
it. You did it in 24:30, faster than the boys.
Yes!
Yay! Yes! Absolutely amazing. Well done. You are the bravest person. Honestly, getting back up and doing that after what you went through must have been very scary. Well done.
Thank you. I need to...
Louise T, everyone. So that means... No. She doesn't have a ticket. It's just from the first two races. Wait, stay with me. Your heart rate went up to 181 beats per minute.
Oh,
it did. Anyway, Chloe, Steve-O and John Allen, sadly, not quick enough from you guys. It means that you guys will be facing the jump. One of you will be going home. How are you feeling?
Yes.
No, you're ready to go. Yeah. Steve-O's ready, come on. Okay, listen, they're all going to be desperate for a place in Sunday's semi-final. They've come so far, and going now would be an absolute nightmare. Getting here hasn't been easy.
Have you had an accident at work recently?
Oh, goodness me, what a cracker.
I've had about 50.
That's called trying really hard to finish first.
We've compiled quite the crash reel. I've seen some mighty falls.
This competition is so brutal.
There's been some fantastic crashes, but then you do have comedy falls as well.
Let's go skate jumping!
When you go down, you feel it then, you feel it the next day, and then you've just got to carry on going.
Every day I wake up, I look forward to a new injury, without a doubt.
I'm gonna look good, man. I feel about broke it or something, man.
First person to hospital, woo!
So I've not broke any bones?
No, definitely not, huh?
No. I've seen some horrendous crashes so far in this competition.
Maybe!
Can't believe people are walking away from them.
It was like being on a motorway, hitting another car.
I think I might have cut my nose a little.
Ooh. Honestly, what was it like just falling over again and again? Because we forget that you guys were learning from scratch.
Oh my gosh, you don't even remember when you fall over, you're just like, bang, I've been taken out, off again.
I mean, like I said to you, Joey, earlier on, you know, you were exhausted this morning, but it just takes it out of you, doesn't it?
Yeah, you just got to keep picking yourself back up again and just doing it, and when you take falls, I think that's where you learn, really, from falling.
And some of the guys from the team yesterday were saying, you know, after a fall like you had on the jump the other day, that any lesser man would have broken a bone. Did you bounce?
Yeah, I think I made of rubber a bit.
Okay, so
luckily there's nothing in my head, so it's all right.
I love Stacey. Stacey was like that. Oh, no, that's not true, Mike. Don't be soft on him. This is Mike Tyndall.
You should see him when he puts his iPod on.
Later. After the break, Chloe and Steve and John Allen take on the air jump. We're going to have to see that at some point. We're so close to the final, but the competition ends for one of them tonight. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to The Jump. It's been a roller coaster of a show tonight. Louise T had a horrible fall in the race and she was severely winded and she was so brave she picked herself up, dusted herself off and beat Chloe, Steve-O and John Allen and has got herself a place in the semi-final. Fantastic, fantastic news for her. So the other three, Chloe, Steve-O and John Allen, they're about to hurl themselves up off our heart-stopping eliminator, the air jump. They're going to do it completely live. The conditions are awful. It's really bad visibility and so cold. Anyway, there are just two semi-final places, so only two will go through and one will be leaving tonight. Here is Graham with a reminder of how it works.
The air jump is a full-sized freestyle kicker, 4 metres in height. That's the height of a double-decker bus. It's about who jumps the highest. They'll be reaching speeds of 30 miles an hour before they hit it. It is very scary when you hit a jump with that much vert at that speed. The air jump is not for the faint-hearted. The biggest danger is taking too much speed and not getting enough height. They'll out-jump the airbag and crash off the end. The celebrities need to be calm, committed, courageous. It really is a case of go big or go home.
Go big or go home. This is all about jumping as high as possible. Chloe's jumping first. She's ready. Over to Barry and Jenny in the commentary box.
As you said, Davina, really difficult conditions. Look at the swirling wind, the mist going across the face of the jumper. A heart rate at 125, Chloe Madeley, but she looks very relaxed and she is a very determined lady. I don't know where you'd put your money on between these three. Got to just about match the bravery of Louise Thompson if they are to make it.
And this is the first time that she's doing this, isn't it? They haven't done the airbag before, so who knows what to expect.
That's true of all of them. This is a question of getting height, which is measured from the bottom of the skis there down to the ground by the high-speed video cameras of Sheffield Hallam University.
Come on, Chloe.
Here she goes.
Oh, she's got a good position. She needs to get a little bit lower if she can to mind that wind. Go on, pop. Yes. Very good. She brought the knees up. Really brought the knees up.
Timing was excellent there, I thought.
I did. I really think she timed the pop, which... Oh, look at that. It's fantastic. Oh, it doesn't matter that she's winding the windows down. She doesn't have to land.
It's set a standard. There's no doubt about that.
Look at that. She really lifts her legs, really pops. And put, yeah, let's hope that's high. Oh, it's got to be high. That's got to be high.
Yay! Way to go, way to go, Chloe. That was awesome. How did that feel to you?
I love it, but I don't know if it was any good. Like, you don't know what's happening.
But did you feel, because I watched you jump earlier in practice, did you feel that that was higher? Because to me it looked higher.
Did it? Oh, that's good. I felt, honestly, you do not know what's happening. You just go, and then you come down and you ask everyone, how did it look? What happened? Because you're just on adrenaline.
Have you found it quite frustrating that it, often in practice runs you do better than, say, with the jump?
I mean, I do. In practice runs, I tend to nail it. And then on the live show, it's just...
How much do you want to make it to the semi-final?
I want to make it to the final. I really do.
Come on! That's winning talk. So, Chloe, let's see how far you jumped. Is it enough to take you to the semi-final?
Oh, okay. Every time I turn in.
6.66 metres, what do you think of that?
It means nothing to me, I don't know what it means.
Well, it means nothing right now, but the other two, that's the height that the other two need to beat. So jumping next, it's Steve-O, back to Barry and Jenny.
Well, I hope you don't mind me saying so, but 666 is supposed to be the devil's number, and it's the guy who thinks he's the daredevil who goes next. Steve-O, he lost to Lady B, wasn't happy about it. Had a collision with Louise Thompson, wasn't happy that he caused her downfall. He's still got a chance to be in the semi-final. And he looks in control. He's got a good one to beat, can
he? He did consider doing this on a snowboard, I think, but he's obviously opting for the skis. Look at the fog. I wonder if that's going to affect him. There's definitely a crosswind, which I'd be a little bit worried about. Oh, he's relaxed. He looks relaxed. Oh, Steve, good. He's tucked nice and low. Drive, drive, drive. Has he got the timing? Oh, it's for the tuck jump. He's holding his boot.
Right, he did really well. Grabbed onto his skis, almost came out of the pit.
I think he went further than he went higher, though, because, like you said, he nearly fell off the end of the bag.
Came in with a little more speed, probably, than Chloe. I think you're right. I think he didn't quite get the same amount of height.
I wonder if he's done enough there to get as high as Chloe. Oh, I bet he really wants to make that semi-final. I know he likes
snowboarding.
Yeah,
Steve definitely had an amazing leg tuck there, but the question was, did he go vertical enough or was it slightly horizontal? What? 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 What are you talking about? It looks so impressive.
I thought it sucked.
Why?
Terribly, because my skis were at an angle. Like, I could totally jump higher. Oh, whatever, we'll see.
You did a good knee tuck. You did.
I tried. Maybe I tried too hard.
So listen, you need to beat Chloe's height of 6.66 metres to be sure of safety. So one of you will be through to Sunday's live semi-final. The other will be in danger of elimination. So, both of you said the same thing. Both of you said it didn't feel good. So anyway, Steve-O, let's have a look. Chloe reached 6.66 metres. You want to get more than that to get through to the semi-final. Steve-O, how far did you jump? You reached a height of 6.57 metres. That means, Chloe, you are safe. You are through to the live semi-final. How are you feeling?
Yay! I'm happy. Really happy.
Oh, no, Steve-O.
How many girls are going to be here?
You can go and join the others.
How many girls are going to
be here? Yeah, loads. Wait, stay there, Steve-O. So, we've got one more jumper to go. So, you are in danger for now. So, either you or John Allen will be leaving us. Right, so John Allen needs to beat Steve-O's height of 6.57 metres for a place in the semi-final. He's ready to go at the top. Back to Barry and Jenny.
John Allen desperately wants to be in the snowboarding because that's where he shines, in his opinion. But he's got to do something a bit special, I think.
I wonder if he's aware of what meters he has to beat here. Come on, John Allen, come on. I really want to see him in the snowboarding.
Well, every challenge he's met head on, as he has in other sequences of his life.
He looks focused.
Does indeed. Does indeed.
Can he get the timing of the pop? Yeah. It's all about the timing of the pop. Come on.
He's away.
Carry that speed. Bring your knees up. Yes. Oh, that was good. That was really good.
It's a contender still. We'll just judge by.
Let's have a look at the side.
Performance.
Oh, his legs were wiggling a little bit there. I think he was trying to get some extra height from somewhere.
He's had one ski a bit lower than the other one.
Yeah, I know. I wonder if they... Oh, good landing.
Here he is. I've got the birthday boy, John Allen. How did you feel about that jump?
I think it was pretty epic. I think I was all right.
Can we just, I don't know if you can see, but John Allen's moustache and beard is actually frozen
every day
here.
Like this. Every day.
So do you think, as far as pulling a jump out of the bag, was that your best one so far? Did it feel?
I think it's on the path of what I've done in training. So it felt pretty good.
That's great. Well, that's what you want to do, is pull out a good jump on the night when you need it. But was it enough to beat Steve-O's height? This would be the best birthday present ever.
Yeah.
Okay, so one of you is going to go through to Sunday's semi-final. One of you is going out. So Steve-O's height was 6.57 metres. Let's find out if you jumped higher. You are through to the semi-final. Oh, 0.03 centimetres.
Doesn't matter about the distance, I just beat him, didn't I?
Yeah, it doesn't matter by how much you beat him.
Exactly.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling quite chuffed, and I didn't want to be in the jump, but...
Come forward. And what a nice birthday present.
A birthday present would be to make it through the first time, but at least I'm through to the next round snowboarding.
You're through to the semi-final. Best birthday present ever. Steve-O, well done, mate. Well done. Okay, so give it up for Steve-O and John Allen, everyone. So we've got our semi-finalists, and on Sunday night, things are going to be turning like totally rad, dude.
The name's Essex. Snowy Essex.
I'm definitely in with a chance of winning.
If you don't back yourself, there's no point in competing.
Mike Tingle isn't good at it. I'm coming to get you.
Okay, look, we're not here tomorrow, but we're back on Sunday at the earlier time of 7 p.m. It's a snowboarding semi-final. Our celebrities are going to do battle for a place in Monday's live grand final, and one of them will leave. So we'll see them for what's bound to be an impressive semi. Until then, good morning from Austria!